Good morning. It is good to be with you this beautiful Sunday morning. It is actually our Bold Women Sunday, which is perfect because it's the start of Women's History Month. So we're celebrating women in our church, women in Scripture, and taking time to send gratitude and make sure we don't forget the important stories of our women. As you get settled for worship, our council president, Hope, will send around folders soon. That's a way of signing in and letting us know you're here, letting me know you need a visit or a phone call. You'll also see in the front folders, there are special giving envelopes for WELCA, Women of the ELCA. That is a special offering. Half of it will go to the WELCA group in our congregation, and the other half will go to the national WELCA organization as well. You can put them in the envelopes during offering time. But for our welcome, we'll hear from Marsha and Seth.
Good morning. Welcome to all of you who are worshiping with us this morning at our Bold Women service here at Joy and online. It is nice to have a Bold Women's service again this year. Because of the COVID pandemic, we were not able to hold this special service since 2020. So we are happy to be celebrating Bold Women again now in 2024. Bold Women's Sunday celebrates all the Lutheran women who have acted or are acting boldly on their faith in Jesus Christ. Some women are bold in their unceasing prayers. Other women are bold in their advocacy or through their hospitality. Still, others are bold in making quilts or prayer shawls for people in need. Others make greeting cards or offer prayers in our prayer ministry. Other women serve on our church council or use their talents in worship and music ministry. Whether we live out our bold story of faith in the workplace or in our family home or community, our faith compels us to make a difference in the lives of others. It's all about living out our baptismal call, being a disciple of Christ. This year's service is special because we have our own bold woman in our recently called woman pastor, Pastor Melissa. We are glad to have you here at Joy, Pastor Melissa, and thank you for your support of Bold Women Sunday and for delivering our message and much of the liturgy this morning. Thank you, too, for all the women, including the Girl Scouts, who are helping with the service today as readers, greeters, musicians, ushers, and communion servers. Thanks, too, for the one man helping us today, Lee Northhouse, doing our technical support as always. In closing, I just want to reiterate what Pastor just mentioned about the Bold Woman Sunday offering. I hope that you all took per family one envelope, and I hope that you will use that blue envelope to put it in the offering this morning. It's a special offering which will be sent to the women of the ELCA, which is headquartered in Chicago, but it will also be used for our own JWELCA support programs here at Joy. Please be generous with your offering, as this will help us help others here at Joy and also advance the work of the women of the ELCA. Thank you so much for coming and for participating in our special service this morning. And now we have our opening call to worship. Is that what it's called, Sue?
For the call to worship this morning, I'm going to be reading that. Made in the image of a bold, beautiful God, we yearn to embody that grace in the world God so loves. We long to tell our authentic truths, to hear and share stories, to nurture one another and serve God's creation. We crave healing and wholeness for all. But sometimes we are overwhelmed, seduced by what is frivolous, distracted from what is important. Teach us when to care and when to step aside. We groan for renewal and change, yet fear that we are not enough can immobilize us. Guilt and shame provoke us to be overly busy and to hide. Teach us when to rest and breathe and when to rise to action. Where can we find rest? How can our lives make a meaningful difference? Teach us when to be silent and still, and teach us when to shout and sing. Remind us you cherish us when we get it right and when we don't. Embolden us to live fully in the freedom of your indestructible love. Show us the way, stay with us while we practice and learn. Hold us always. Amen.
I invite you to rise as you are comfortable for our opening song. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Why, thank you so much. Please be seated. And join me in the prayer of the day on our screen. God of tender care, like a mother, you never forget your children, and you already know what we need. In all our anxiety, give us trusting and faithful hearts, that in confidence and boldness, we may embody the peace and justice of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At this time, I invite any of our littlest Lutherans to come on up, any of our youth in the room today. You are serving communion today. Come on up, my friends. You want to stand on this side by everybody? Good morning, good morning. We're a little slow and groggy this morning. That's okay. Good morning, good morning. I have a question for you all first, my friends. We've been talking about bold women today, women that are strong and smart and do really amazing things. Do you all know any bold women in your lives? Mama. Your mom, awesome. Jonathan, who are you going to say? Yeah. Your mom, too.
Grandma.
Grandma, good. Who else? Yes, Steffi. Who? Are you a bold woman, Stephanie? Your cousins? Good. How many of you are bold women in the room? There should be so many hands up. I see so many of you. That's wonderful. So Bold Women Sunday, we talk about how the women in our lives, the women in the congregation and out in the world, they look like God too. So this is a book that you'll see in the sanctuary, in the narthex. Let me try again. In the fellowship hall too. We have so many rooms. Forget the names. This book is called Maybe God Is Like That Too, and it's written by Jennifer Grant. And in the story, there's this little boy about your age who is asking his grandma, what does God look like? What is God like? And his grandma tells him many stories. And what do you know? He starts to pay attention. And on this page, it says, at bedtime, grandma sits at the edge of my bed singing me a lullaby and stroking my head. She tucks my blankets up and close around me. That's what God looks like to me. Maybe God is like that too. So God looks like a lot of different things. Sometimes it can look like our grandmas and grandpas and different bold women in our lives, in the world, and even in our family. And the boy says at the end, I saw God over and over and over again today. Wherever I saw love and joy and peace, wherever there was patience, kindness, and goodness. When I saw faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control, I saw God's Spirit at work. So wherever we see God at work, sometimes it's in the bold women that we're celebrating today. Maybe it's in our parents and grandparents and the other adults in this place. And guess what? It's also in each one of you all, right? You all are loving and gentle and kind and strong and smart, and you all do so many amazing things, and all of that reflects God's love too, right? Will you say a prayer with me in closing? Show me your good pray hands. Good pray hands, and congregation is going to help us with call and response. Dear God, thank you for your love, and bold women who share your love. Amen. Now, as you go on your way to Sunday school or the nursery or wherever, give some high fives to some bold women you see on the way. Give some high fives on your way out. Beautiful. Look at all those high fives. And congregation, you can high five some people around you too. And we continue with special music. We start with our bell quintet. Quintet.
Thank you.
Thank you. You all did a wonderful job. We appreciate all the different women sharing their gifts and talents today. And now we turn our hearts and minds to our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who writes the law on our hearts, who draws all people together through Jesus. Amen. Held in God's mercy, let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. We'll take a moment for silent, prayerful reflection. Holy God, we confess that we are caught in the snares of sin and cannot break free. We hoard resources while our neighbors are hungry and cold. We speak in ways that silence others. We are silent when we should speak up. We keep score in our hearts. We let hurts grow into hatred. For all these things and for sins only you know, forgive us, O Lord. Amen. Beloved church, here is a flood of grace from God. Out of the love for the whole world, God draws near to us, breaks every snare of sin, washes away all of our wrongs, and restores the promise of life. Through Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. And we continue with our readings.
A capable wife, who can find? She is far more precious than jewels. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. Strength and dignity are her clothing. She laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household, and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy, her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share of the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the city gates.
This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Okay, so the gospel is from Mark 14, not what's in your bulletin, verses 3 through 9. That was the clarification, so I read the correct thing. While he was in Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, as he sat at the table, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very costly ointment of nard, and she broke open the jar and poured the ointment on his head. But some were there who said to another in anger, "Why was the ointment wasted in this way? For this ointment could have been sold for more than 300 denarii and the money given to the poor." And they scolded her. But Jesus said, "Let her alone. Why do you trouble her? She has performed a good service for me. For you have always the poor with you, and you can show kindness to them whenever you wish. But you will not always have me. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body before its burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her." This is the gospel of our Lord.
So if you are a woman or know of a woman who ever goes against the grain, you'll know that you're bound to hear some grumbling. Ask any, well, there's already some nods. Ask any woman, and they'll tell you a story about people who have grumbled at her for being unladylike. For whatever reason, certain behaviors are seen as unladylike, and it just leads to certain grumbling from people. And you can notice this all the way through our history. Women, especially women of color, haven't had access to the same freedoms as men for most of their lives. Women were supposed to be housewives and mothers or nuns, and that was it. Those were your only options. They were not allowed to have jobs, which means they couldn't own property, which means they couldn't have credit cards, which some of our women have talked about in Bible studies, is they couldn't always have credit cards. Women weren't always allowed to have a vote in government or in the church or different places, or a voice or opinion, which means they really weren't supposed to be pastors like me or deacons in the church or have any sort of leadership role. Only nuns or Sunday school teachers, but otherwise they were to be quiet, seen and not heard, you might have heard before. And the history of women's accomplishments have gone underreported and often forgotten. Even in Scripture, women go unnamed, their stories forgotten and untold. Even in biblical times, there are people grumbling about the faithful actions of women. Like in our gospel reading today, Jesus is preparing for his final days before he is crucified. Jesus has been teaching his disciples about his upcoming death and resurrection, and it's rustled some feathers with Peter and the disciples who don't want him to die. Judas, right after the scripture reading, is about to make a deal with the chief priest to sell Jesus and have him arrested. And right after this is the Last Supper. We are at the tail, almost at Holy Week in this scripture. And we don't know much about this woman at Bethany. She, like many other women in scripture and history, doesn't have a name or a history or any other story besides the one you've heard today. But we can assume that she was a faithful follower of Jesus Christ, and somehow she had money of her own to spend. The woman knew Jesus was about to suffer and die, and she wanted to care for Jesus while he was still with them. She anoints his head with oil. Some other scriptures say his feet, but she actually anoints his head with oil. And this is a special action that is reserved for anointing someone as a prophet, a priest, or a king. When you anoint their head, it's a special task. And the anointing of the head is only to be done by other prophets. And prophets are people who are called by God to proclaim the good news. So this woman from Bethany, who is unnamed, is taking on a prophetic role. And she is anointing Jesus as the king, the Messiah. She must have been a follower of Jesus. She must have known who he was, witnessed his miracles, heard his stories, and came to believe for herself that he was indeed the Messiah, the Son of God. But this act, this faithful, powerful, prophetic act, led to some grumbling from people around her. They were complaining about the cost of the oil that would have been a year's wages for a day laborer. So a year's worth of money for a regular blue-collar worker, which most of the disciples were. They were fishermen or farmers at that time. And it was broken open, the jar was broken, so it all had to be used at that moment, and it was poured on Jesus' head to anoint him as the Messiah. This is no small task that she did. It might feel small, but it's actually a powerful, empowering, prophetic task that she performs. It was evidence of her discipleship and love and faith to Jesus. While everyone was around her grumbling about her being wasteful, this woman was clearly dedicating all that she had, all of her life and her resources, to following Jesus. And Jesus stands up to the grumbling, and he says, "Truly, I tell you, wherever the good news is proclaimed in the whole world, what she has done will be told in remembrance of her." Jesus says she will be remembered in the whole world. wherever the good news is preached, this act of faith by this unnamed woman will be remembered. Jesus doesn't say this about anyone else in the Gospels. Not his disciples, not the apostles, not anyone he heals or feeds, not even his own mother. He says this only about this woman at Bethany, this unnamed woman who performs a powerful prophetic act. Jesus declares that her story and her life will not be forgotten. And that's why we have this Bold Women Sunday, so that we never forget or take for granted or trivialize or grumble at the work women have done in the church and in the world. We declare that we will not forget this prophetic act of the woman at Bethany who anointed Jesus Messiah. And we won't forget the women who came before her and after her either. We won't forget the widow who gave the last of her money to the church, her last 3 coins as an act of faith. We won't forget the woman who suffered bleeding for over 12 years and moved through the crowd just to touch the fringes of Jesus' cloak and be healed. And we won't forget the woman at the well who told her whole community about Jesus Christ, and all of them came to believe. These women are unnamed, but we will remember them. And we won't forget the women from the Old Testament who were prophets and queens and deacons and mothers and leaders and rule breakers. Women who cover our pillars as you walk out into the entryway. Women like Hagar, who is a foreign slave, who is the first to name God Elroy, which means God who sees. Then there's Miriam, who saves baby Moses from being killed by Pharaoh and then journeys alongside him as a prophet. She is named a prophet. And then there's Rahab, who we'll hear about in Women's Bible Study this week, who protects the Israelite people with her cunningness. And then there's Ruth and Naomi, who cling to each other and prove that love survives any trauma and any heartbreak. And of course, Mary, the woman who birthed Jesus, who raised him and encouraged him and also became one of his disciples. And when Jesus was hanging on the cross, all of the other disciples had run away and didn't want to be near, but she sat there at his feet till he drew his last breath. She never left him. And then we won't forget, of course, the bold women who were the first to find the empty tomb on Easter morning. Alongside the act of this woman who anointed Jesus, these women were the first to proclaim that Jesus Christ is the Messiah. He is the Son of God. He destroyed all powers of sin and death, and he is indeed resurrected. I know it's early, it's Lent, but we're going to proclaim it anyway, that Jesus has already been resurrected. We will not forget any of these bold women and the women I have had not had time to name. It would take us all day. Wherever the good news is preached, which includes right here at Joy Lutheran Church, we will remember the bold women of faith who came before us to show us the way. We will remember the bold women who paved the way for more of our freedoms, the freedoms to vote and have voice, the freedom to be a pastor. I don't take that for granted, the women who made this easier for me. We will remember the women who proclaim Christ's love in word and deed, whether it's quilting or card making or all of the different ministries you all hold. We will give thanks for all of these bold women and the bold women that surround us today and are watching online and the ones that we hold so dear in our hearts. May their faith be an inspiration for us. May we have the courage to boldly proclaim our faith and serve those who are in need, despite the grumbling we might hear. We pursue justice and peace in the name of God anyway. May we be bold enough to see the light of Christ reflected in ourselves and in each other and the bold women around us. Thanks be to God. Amen. I forgot to mention earlier that all of our songs are written by or performed by women. The first song, Beautiful Things, was written by a woman named Lisa Gunger. This song is from a common hymn you probably know, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. Come Thou Fount, well, you'll hear it. But it's rewritten. I lost the tune. I need to hear the piano. The words are rewritten to "Come, O Stories of Our Mothers." It is written by Reverend Seminarian Katie Mueller, who's a dear friend of mine. She's from Appleton, Wisconsin, so she's one of our own local soon-to-be pastors. And she rewrote this for Women's History Day 2 years ago. So I invite you to stand as you are comfortable to sing. Like the bold women before us, we are gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, and let us profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who is conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and he is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We continue with our prayers led by Kathy.
Let us pray together with the response, receive our prayer. God, our Creator, you made us in your image, and you call us from wherever we are in time and place to be your disciples. Through your Holy Spirit, we are empowered to bring the gospel to all your people by your grace. You listen to our prayers. God of generations, we celebrate the lives of the women who fought the good fight and stood up for the gospel and the truth of Scripture yesterday and today. Strengthen our voice of proclamation in your mercy.
Receive our prayer.
God of life, we give thanks for the bold women among us today who serve with a sense of holy purpose in their vocations as friends, daughters, mothers, grandmothers, great-grandmothers, sisters, and mothers. Empower us by faith and bless our vocations at home, in the church, and in the world. Inspire us to encourage one another in fellowship, laughter, hospitality, and sharing. In your mercy, receive our prayer. Loving God, we pray for the men throughout the ages who support and encourage women in their quest to use their God-given gifts for your purpose. Give us courage to work together as equals to proclaim your grace and hope. In your mercy, receive our prayer. O God, our greatest friend, surround us with your love and affirmation through the kindness of others, be they friend or stranger, young or old. Help us witness the love you lavish on all your people. Make us bold to speak your truth and act on behalf of your kingdom with courage and strength of purpose. In your mercy, receive our prayer. God of understanding, give us courage to stand up for the abused, the needy, the sick, the poor, and the stranger. We pray for those who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, that you might bring healing and comfort, especially those we name aloud or silently in our hearts. Inspire us to be your hands to provide for those in need as we are able. In your mercy,
receive our prayer.
O God, our help through the ages, we thank you for the gifts of wisdom and insight brought to us through the lives of your saints. Inspire us by their witness as we continue their legacy of faith. In your mercy,
receive our prayer.
Holy God of the universe, throughout history you have given us the courage to form and reform your church against all odds and into pathways as yet unknown. By your Spirit, and in unexpected ways, you have brought us to this place in the circle of your love. Guide our ways that we may grow in faith and hope. Make us your bold and faithful servants, this day and forevermore, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
There are many ways in which bold women have been servants in our church and the world, and at this time we're going to offer a blessing for them. So if you identify as a woman, I invite you to stand as you are comfortable. If you are holding a very small little woman, you can also stand with them as well. Whether it's your first day in the congregation or 100th day, I invite you to stand as you are comfortable. Dear sisters in Christ, you have dedicated your life to the service of the church and to the world. You have taken the promise of your baptism seriously, a promise to give thanks and praise to God and bear God's creative and redeeming word to all of the world. You have done so in your occupations, working at schools, hospitals, churches, nonprofits, corporations, large and small, and places I forgot to name. You have done so in your volunteer work, quilting, cleaning the church, leading Bible studies, Sunday school, confirmation, serving on church council, volunteering for local nonprofits, and in advocating for justice and love for all and many other places I forgot to name. You have done so in the beauty you create as artists, actresses, poets, authors, and musicians. You have done so in your many relationships as friends, daughters, sisters, aunts, mothers, wives, grandmothers, and great-grandmothers, and godparents, and aunts, and so many other roles. Whether you care for family, children, spouses, pets, or plants, you have dedicated your life to caring for many all around you. Like the women who found the empty tomb and first proclaimed Christ's resurrection, you have boldly proclaimed God's love in the world and in this church. You have done all of this and so much more. On this day, I invite you to reaffirm your work you do as bold women in the church and in the world. So, sisters in Christ, bold women of God, both your work and your rest are in God. Will you endeavor to pattern your life on the Lord Jesus Christ in gratitude to God and in service to others at morning and evening, at work and at play, all the days of your life? I will, and I ask God to help me. I invite you now to put a short hand on some bold woman that is near you, or just extend a hand out towards someone, and we'll offer a prayer and blessing on them. Men, you too, put a hand out to our ladies. I'll put a hand over all of you. Almighty God, by the power of your Spirit, you have knit these servants into the body of your Son, Jesus Christ. Look with favor upon them in their commitment to serve in Christ's name. Give them courage, patience, and vision, and strengthen us all in the Christian vocation of witness to the world and service to others. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And as it is comfortable, let's offer a round of applause for our bold women in the congregation. And before you take your seats, may the peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Why, thank you so much. Please share a sign of peace with those around you. You may take your seats. I know there's a lot of peace to go around. Are you guys? Okay. As we continue with receiving our offering, I invite you to, I'm the one pastor who's going to tell you, you can take out your phones and worship. Feel free to text a bold woman in your life if you would like that you are thankful for them. And we'll continue with receiving our offering. And join me in saying a prayer for our offering. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts that we may be this world's precious present in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. This communion liturgy is a little more formal than we normally do. It was spoken at my ordination, and it centers the stories of women and the song of Mary that she sang when she was pregnant. The congregation will read the bolded verses. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks and praise to our Lord God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so with all of the choirs of angels and the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name. All praise to you, glorious God of grace. Throughout the ages, you have blessed us with foremothers of the faith. With Sarah, we bless you for your gift of life. With Ruth, we praise you for family and food. With Miriam, we celebrate our escape from the foe. Remembering Deborah, we honor the words of your prophets. Remembering the woman at the well, we laud you for living water. Remembering Junia, we thank you for those who minister among your people. One with the daughters of Jairus, we wake to life in you. With Mary, we magnify your name. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Remembering Martha and Mary, we join Jesus at this meal. Living, he healed the bleeding woman. Dying, he cared for his mother. Risen, he sent Mary Magdalene in mission. On the night before he died, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant for you in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." With Mary, again, we magnify your name. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit, can you go back a slide, Lee? Thank you. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. Mighty God of mercy, as you heard the prayers of Hannah, so now hear us. Send your spirit on this bread and wine, that sharing the body and the blood of Christ, we become his body in the world. Send your spirit on this assembly, that like Phoebe we may serve one another with zeal. Send your spirit on the church, that like Anna we tell others of your mercy. Send your spirit into our hearts, that like Dorcas we care for the poor and needy. With Mary once more we magnify your name. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices, God my Savior. All praise to you, powerful God of peace. We adore you, our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You who mother and feed us and comfort us today, tomorrow, and forever. And together we say, Amen. Now, gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that God is good. All are welcome to God's table. The bread is gluten-free, dairy-free, nut-free, completely free for you, thanks to God. And thanks for the giggle. That is the best way to say thank you to a pastor. And then there is white juice and red wine, and you'll dip your bread in it. If you drop it in there, just let us know. We'll give you extra bread. If you accidentally eat the bread, don't take it out of your mouth. Let us know, and we'll give you a new bread. Thank you. But I'll invite my communion servers, the bold women servers, to come forward first. Now that we have been fed, receive this blessing. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. Gracious God, in this meal you have drawn us to your heart and nourished us at your table with food and drink, the body and blood of Christ. Now send us forth to be your people in the world and to proclaim your truth on day and evermore. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Now, before you go on your way, I have a few announcements. Firstly, hold our confirmation students in prayer. They had a beautiful retreat this weekend. They are 2 months away from confirmation, so hold them in prayer as they prepare to make their faith statements and reaffirm their baptismal promises as well. There are 9 ninth graders who will be confirmed in 2 months. They are delightful human beings. I hope you come hang out with us. This week, it's all about women this week. It's first week of Women's History Month, so that's just how it goes. But on Tuesday, March 5th at 1:30, and Wednesday, March 6th at 7:15, we're doing a women's Bible study on Rahab. Same study, 2 times. If you like to read ahead, we're reading Joshua chapters 2 and 6 on Rahab. If you want a spoiler alert, check out the pillars as you leave. There's a little a big poster that I made on Rahab. And pillars from other folks made by our 6th, 7th, 8th, and 9th graders out there. Next week is daylight saving time, so make sure to set your clocks ahead on Saturday night so you won't be late to church. I love you all, but I'm only doing service once if you're late, so. Or just watch it online. It's okay. Even superheroes run late for church, but we're excited to see you all. We're rebooting service teams. Talk to council if you're interested, or me or the office. We are doing different adult forums after worship, and this week, as you go into the fellowship hall after you grab your treats, you'll see a long line of art that I've set up that tells the story of different biblical women, the story of my own faith journey, and some art from different women in our congregation. It is absolutely stunning. Take a moment to look through it. And as you go into, you'll see a table with thank you cards. Feel free to write a thank you card to a bold woman in your life. Either hand deliver it yourself, or if it has the full address on it and it's sealed, leave it in the basket and we'll mail it for you. Or third option, if you want to thank yourself for being a bold woman, which you should do, write yourself a thank you card, address it, seal it, and on the back, write us what date you would like it sent, and I will make sure it gets sent to you on the day you would like it. So maybe your baptism anniversary or your birthday or whenever. Pick a random day. We're doing Hold an Evening Prayer through Wednesdays. If you want to hang out with the kids, that's a good time to come hang out with the kids. There are quilts up here as well that the quilters have been diligently making. We also have posters from Lutheran World Relief, who receives the quilts, so it gives you a little story on where they go and the impact they have. Dinner on Wednesday is fajita chicken. And yeah, check out the art in the fellowship hall before you leave. That on the right is Blessed Are You Among Women, made by Sister Ansgar Holmberg. She is a sister I got to know during my year of service. And it's Elizabeth on the left and Mary, Mother of Jesus, on the right. And that's all. So,
can I say something?
Yeah, go.
Bells of the Bluffs had a fundraiser last night down at the Red Wing Legion. And due to a small miscommunication between food server shifts, rather than thinking we were out of coleslaw, there were a ton of individual servings in the refrigerator. So I have brought a bunch of individual servings of coleslaw here to Joy because I can't freeze that. So I'll put them out at Fellowship Hall if you can pick some up.
Coleslaw, coffee, and muffins, all in the... It's a good combination. That's good. Thank you, Joan. Before our final song, let me send you on your way with this blessing. Go and take your place in the lineages of love and liberation that we might midwife God's future into the here and now. May God, our Creator, equip us, the Spirit sustain us, and Christ will lead us. With joy, let us rise and follow. Amen. Please stand as you are comfortable for our last song. And kids, bring up the instruments. Yeah.
My Jesus, my Savior, though there is none like you, all of my days I want to praise the wonder of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, power of refuge and strength.
God's beloved.